Welcome to this session, Ironic towards truly open and reliable, eventually for mission critical. I'm Naohiro Tamura from Fujitsu. My presentation consists of four parts: introduction, vision, contribution, and conclusion. I took my presentation title from the midterm vision, truly open and reliable, and long-term vision, eventually mission critical, because vision part is the core of this presentation. So let me introduce myself and the company I'm working for. I joined the Ironic community at the beginning of Kiro development cycle and focused on Ironic driver development. Before that, I mainly worked on the proprietary software development for system management. I developed bare metal provisioning and IO virtualization for N plus one redundancy by enhancing PXC server on legacy BIOS and UEFI. OpenStack is my first open source project. It's a whole new experience for me. I'd like to mention two things. The joyful part is working with talented and smart people. And interesting phenomenon is bike shaking. If I didn't get involved in OSS community, I would not never know it. And here is my contact information. What is Fujitsu good at? Fujitsu sustains many social infrastructures: parking, stock exchange, factory automation, government agency system, and so on. For example, Tokyo Stock Exchange trading system running on the standard IA server and open source Linux and Fujitsu's in-memory database, all we integrated into the one system and running very well. So Fujitsu is good at the mission critical system. So let me explain the vision. First of all, I'd like to mention the customer value. So what are the most important things for customer? Three values we see. The first one is truly open, no vendor lock-in. That is to provide the customer with freedom to switch any vendor anytime. The second, reliable, robust, highly available system. That is to operate the customer's business continuously without losing any business opportunity. The third, responsive and responsible and competent support. That is to resolve customers' incident quickly and accurately. I think most of us experienced that when we ask some questions to the customer support, it takes more than 1 week, or if you are unlucky, it takes more than 1 month. And so that is not good. So midterm vision is open, truly open and reliable. How should truly open and reliable be? The hint is here. Let me explain by using Android as a reference model. Used to be in the smartphone market, the iOS was the leader. But current Android is leader, and more than 80% of shipment is Android. So no vendor lock-in situation are created. The customer can switch from one vendor to other vendor whenever she or he wants because of truly open and reliable. So if we apply Android model, we can project the future. Currently, the cloud market, the big four mega the leader, Amazon, MS, IBM, and Google. And if cloud system become truly open and reliable, customer can switch from one cloud to another cloud. So interoperability is a key for the mega locking among public, private, and hybrid cloud. More specifically, if we apply this model to Ironic, so this table summarizes the situation comparison between the Android and Ironic. So Ironic will be a data center server hardware specification if market accepts Ironic as Android defines the hardware. And the customer will be switched anytime to whichever vendor, hardware vendor, she or he likes, as Android realizes this situation. Also, from API CLI UI's point of view, Ironic will have the same functionality to all bare metal servers as Android already realized. From user's point of view, all smartphones have same functionality. But hardware reliability and support responsiveness will be a differentiator among vendors, as Android also these are the differentiator. So how can we achieve truly an open, reliable situation? I think we need two steps. First of all, we need to complete the following table to create the same situation as Android. That is no vendor lock-in situation. If you can look at this table, you will notice that the check marks are scattered. So that means currently no vendor lock-in situations are not created. So the the horizontal axis shows the interface. It's also a function. The power, boot, deploy, management, inspect, clean, raid, rescue. And vertical axis shows each vendor. The IPMI is not a vendor, but this is a standard driver of the Ironic, so I put it here. The green mark are the contribution we made, and yellow mark is we are contributing, and pink mark we are planning to contribute. I'm going to explain the later slide. The next step is then enhance proactive and reactive feature to achieve higher reliability. Long-term vision, eventually mission critical. Can you imagine that Tokyo Stock Exchange trading system runs inside Ironic? Unfortunately, no, I can't right now, because stock market involves huge amount of investing money. So if failure happens, it causes a lot of loss and trouble. So, but our vision is really challenging and ironic for mission critical. We believe that it's difficult to achieve this vision just by a company, but we believe that we can achieve this vision by a community because there are a lot of things to be done. The next section, I'm explaining the contribution we have done and we are doing and what we are going to do. This contribution is to realize mid-term vision, not the long-term vision. The long-term vision will be achieved accumulating small steps. So midterm vision, we need a telescope. Complete the cable I showed previous slide for clearly open and proactive and reactive feature for reliability. These contributions are based on this idea. I expand the what we have done part here. We implemented the virtual media deployment in the Kilo and Liberty cycle. So what is it good for? The virtual media enables the out-of-band boot. So this is good for multi-tenant and network storage environment. This is the element technology, and we are going to use it in the future, that are the risky mode in tenant network and the bare metal and plus one redundancy. I'm going to explain later. So how does it work? So before explaining how does it work, I summarize the ironic deploy basic. There are two types of method, two types of image, two types of boot method, two types of image, two types of deploy method. The virtual media is out of band. On the other hand, the PXE is inbound. The type of image deploy is a temporary image to load user's image. We sometimes use different terminology. The deployment image also known as deploy RAM disk, and user image also known as boot RAM disk or instance boot image or user instance. We support both iSCSI and Ironic Path Agent. I'm explaining the difference. So first of all, this is the iSCSI IRMC driver. How does it work? We put deploy ISO image here. This is a virtual ISO image. The ironic connector here, and the next one is the ironic API. And this is the target of the bare metal. And here is the image server. Typically, this is the glance. But not only glance, we support just plain HTTP server as an image service. So first, conductor create virtual flop image, which has a parameter for the deploy image, and attach virtual, issue the command to BMC and attach virtual the floppy and CD-ROM, and boot the deploy image. And the deploy image export local disk as an iSCSI target and call Ironic API to continue. Then Ironic API dispatch request to Ironic conductor. Then conductor call image service and download boot image to the Ironic conductor and cache it. And attach local disk by iSCSI and conductor copy the image by DD to local disk. Then boot user's image from the local disk. That is the whole story of the iSCSI virtual media. So now this is agent IRMC. The first step is the same. Second step is also the same. The third step is all the same. So now IPA is loaded into the bare metal server, and IPA export IPA API and call Ironic API to Heartbeat. Then the Ironic API dispatch the request to conductor. Then the conductor call back to IPA API to start boot image download. So this is a different step from the iSCSI driver. IPA directly download the image from the image service into the local disk, but via HTTP or HTTPS. Then the conductor call IPA API to see if the demo has been done. If it's been done, then boot from the local disk. So this is the whole step of the agent IRMC. The next, currently we are working on software power off and inject MMI. Here is a use case. Software power off use case has two cases. The unscheduled hardware maintenance. So that is for cloud provider, because cloud provider cannot log in customer's instance. So they need to safely shut down the customer's OS. So even though scheduled hardware maintenance, sometimes customer didn't shut down, so soft power off is necessary. The use case of inject MMI, the cloud provider support can support team can ask customer to provide OS dump to resolve customer incident quickly and accurately. This is realized for the customer, third customer value, responsive and responsive support. And the customer can investigate the problem by themselves if they don't want sensitive data export outside, because dump data might have credit card information in it. The benefit of software power off and inject NMI. The current power off of the Ironic as of Liberty. This is a hard power off. If, imagine that if in memory database is running, then the human sometimes there are error. So if accidentally type ironic node power off, power state off, then this called hardware power off. That is not good, really not good. So the soft power off shut down the OS gracefully. And the shutdown sometimes takes a long time, so it's also abortable. And inject NMI enables responsible support, as I explained. And inject NMI behaves like a reboot, and it takes OS dump when reboot has been done. So in order to implement these two operations, power control is so basic, but if we try to implement seriously, it's not so easy and not so simple. We need to handle two states. One is just state, the other is target state. You can see that these two states if you type ironic node shell state, as shown in this slide. The current implementation, there is no distinction between stable state and target state. So both use power on and power off. That's the reason I use dashed rectangle. So I'm going to, I'm proposing right now to enhance to add two new power target state. That is power soft off and inject NMI. These two target state distinguish between the other, the power, just plain hard power, power off and power on. And the most difficult part is to support abort. So I'm going to explain how to support about in this slide. And how to handle abort or cancel timeout exception of background is very common problem in the concurrent problem. In case of Python, the thread is grassly thread, but regardless of thread is real or green, we can use the same approach. Proposing to use a communication sequential process channel and channel registry such as the ARM process. So here is a step. The Ironic API issues soft power off, then the periodical loop starts, then the node is locked. Then this green thread gets a channel from the channel registry for the node, this specific node. Then read a channel. So if channel is empty, the continuously loop. Then the API issue abort. Then another green thread invoked. Then this green thread gets the channel from the registry. Then send the abort message to the channel. Then the power off loop reads the channel, then the get the abort message, then the this loop exit. Then unlock the node. This is how to implement I'm proposing right now. The next, what we are going to do, there are two features. These two features I already submitted to the blueprint. The first, rescue mode. So if you know the KVM of Nova, this is the same. So as I mentioned earlier, I use the virtual media in here. But in this case, I explain the PXE inbound boot and flip network, the case path. So here, single is a network storage. This single has an instance image. And the deploy image is provided to the deploy network through the PXE. Then if instance image is loaded in the single, then network is flipped to the tenant network. So what if instance is damaged? So we need to boot rescue image from the PXE boot. So that creates need a rescue network. Then after rescue image booted from the PXE, we need to fix the instance image on single. So that means we need to change the network settings. So now bare metal one server has a different network configuration from the production environment, which could make rescue difficult because some other problem might happen. So we proposing to use virtual media, which provide out-of-band rescue mode. If rescue image booted from the virtual image, we can keep tenant network as is, which means this configuration is same as real instance. So there is no room to another problem introduced due to the network setting change. The other function, the bare metal n plus one redundancy, I'm going to explain what is it. So if you know the KVM live migration, this is similar. This is a bare metal server, so we cannot do the live migration, but we can do the cold migration. This network is multi-tenant and network storage environment. And N plus one means if a server is three, so that means N plus one means here is a spare server. If one server is damaged, we can switch to the other bare metal in very short time. So assume the bare metal server one has a sign of failure, and then we type or automatically invoke ironic cold migration bare metal server one. Then the ironic detect spare server. First of all, we need to shut down. In order to shut down, we use the graceful shutdown we are implementing right now. So after safely shut down bare metal server one, so conductor find out spare server, then the migration image booted from the virtual media. Then this migration ISO set the same IO setting to attach signal as the setting in the bare metal server one. Then boot. This spare server has same functionality as bare metal server one. So this function increase the reliability. So recap my presentation. I presented the customer value first. Based on our observation or perception, we see three customer values: truly open, no vendor lock-in, reliable, robust, and highly available system, responsive, responsible, complex support. In order to realize these customer value, we set two midterm vision: truly open and reliable. The relation is presented by Arrow. And based on our midterm vision, we implemented virtual media deployment, which contribute to realize truly open. And we are right now working on the software power off and injection MI, which increase reliability. And then using these two element technology, we are proposing rescue mode in tenant network and bare metal N plus one redundancy. Then we are aiming long-term vision, eventually for mission critical. So conclusion, so let's make Ironic great product. Thanks. If you have a question, please go to the mic and ask the question. Yeah, if you don't have any question, then the presentation is the end. Thank you very much. I will be around.